Welcome back to the Talos Principle. Okay, we have one more red puzzle to do in this area, and then we should be done, although after I finish this red puzzle, I do want to go outside of bounds and see if I can find anything special, since in the near the end of the last episode, I did figure out how to do that, how to get outside of the walls, but I've not used it yet. But let's solve this last red puzzle first. Oh wait, that's not where it is. I went the totally wrong way. I guess I should actually follow the signs that I'm looking at. That could be helpful. Eagle's Nest. Okay, so it's just right in there. Looks easy enough. Obviously, it's going to be much harder than it looks, of course. That takes me inside. Okay. This takes me nowhere. What's over there? I wonder how you get in there. And there's stairs that lead up to here, which implies that I need to do something here. Like, at some point I'm gonna walk up there, maybe? But if I walk up there, then at that point I've already gotten... Yeah, at that point I've already gotten the red sigil, so... No, I don't think that's used in solving the puzzle, I think that's just used to get out. I guess both blocks just go inside? I don't see what possible use they could have outside. Oh. Wait, what just happened? Did it just cut off the blue light? It did. Enough to turn it off for a second. Okay, and the reason I want to turn it off is so I can disable the fan, which would allow me to walk inside. Yes, yes. So it seems kind of similar to Whoosh, that other puzzle, where it's a fan that's blowing at me to stop me from getting to where I need to go. If I could get both boxes inside, I could probably make a stack of two boxes right here, jump on top of it, and then block the blue with my body. But they just fly over, so I don't think that's gonna happen. Okay, well there's no way I can just run over fast enough, right? Quickly! Quickly! No, not even close. So, what does that mean? How can I put the boxes on a timer? I could make a stack of two. I don't know what that would actually do. Well, that was pointless. There's really not that much to do with this puzzle. So it's kind of amazing that it's perplexing, because there's very little to work with. One van, one laser beam, pretty much. I don't know. I really have no idea. It's gotta be something really simple. I'm gonna think about this one and I'll be right back. Oh, wait a minute! I think I just figured it out. Yeah! How about this? Why don't I ride the box inside? Okay, that didn't quite work. I tried to run off of it, but it seemed like I couldn't. Let me try that again. Let me off! Shit. Why can't I jump off of it? That's really weird. Let's see. Okay, so if I jump here, I actually get a little bit of extra height, which means I might be able to jump on a 2-stack. I don't see how that would help, but let me see if I can do it. Okay. Cool, cool. Can I jump over this? Oh shit, I just screwed myself. No, I have to reset it. I can't climb ladders with objects in my hand. Damn you! It's alright, there's like no setup time in this puzzle room. So again, I don't think a stack of two boxes really accomplishes anything, but let's see what happens when I launch myself. Whoa, what the hell? I tried jumping like right before I actually placed the object to see if maybe it wouldn't stick me to it, and it did something. It just launched me like straight up in the air. I feel like this is the key to solving it, but it seems strangely finicky. Like, it keeps sticking me to the box and it really just doesn't want me to move. Oh, ooh, there we go! Yes, go! Okay. Cool. Okay, it's all the red pieces, all the stars here. Only thing left to do is go out of bounds. Think I can get to the pyramid out there? Nah. I'd reach the end of the world long before that. Nothing special I could do here. Given that stack of two boxes... Hold on, I'm curious. What if I just ride the stack normally? Like, don't try to jump off. How far can it take me? Okay, it actually pushes me off. Oh, so I actually didn't even have to do any jump. That's weird, if there's a stack of two boxes, it just pushes you off, but if there's one box, it takes you all the way, I think. Didn't take me all the way over. Yeah. Okay. Well, let's go out of bounds, shall we? I think I'm gonna have to redo some setup for this puzzle. Is this the right room? No. It was whoosh. Alright, so I'm gonna go get back to the place where I was just about ready to jump over the outer wall and get out of bounds, and I'll be right back. Okay, here we go. Little hippity hop up here, and then let's see what we can find. Is there any reason for me to stay on the wall? Whoops. I don't know what the hell that is. I think it's just a visual glitch of some sort. Thing down there, around the corner, no. Well, so you could have actually used this trick to just grab the shape right here. Could have skipped solving this entire puzzle. Way too high to jump up to. Oh, you know, I need to remember that I can take a box with me. In fact, I absolutely should take a box with me. Or should I? If I get trapped somewhere where I can't get back, then I'm gonna lose the box and I'm gonna have to set up this entire room again. But if I take the box with me, I could potentially get to some areas that I couldn't before. So yeah, let's take one. Gonna go third person so I can actually see myself better. I don't think there's anything of interest in here, so let's just go out of bounds. Looking for things buried in the sand. Okay, can't go too far that way. Interesting. It's a floating wall. Cool. Whoa! Holy shit! Fucking hell, that scared me! Interesting, okay. There's no collision there, cool. Jesus. I didn't expect to sink through the world. Really gave me a fucking heart attack, okay. Thankfully, it put me back in this puzzle room and didn't reset everything, so... it's easy enough to get back. Okay, don't go there. Note to self. Why is there no collision there? That's weird, because I've been a lot of places out of bounds, and they've always had collision before. Okay, so I can use my box to help me get up here. Cool. Or, oh, ah, oh, fucking balls. There's an invisible wall. Can I get back up there? I want my box back. Give me my box back, man. I need it. Let me just try that again. Yep, there is definitely a wall there. Okay. So you're really, really not meant to go there.
The beginning were the word.
The beginning were the words. Can't go that way. Alright, let me see if I can get up on this corner here. No! Stay upright, please. Crap. Okay. Perhaps I should go the other way. Taking my box and I'm going home. Ooh, oh, yep. Well, I guess maybe there's just nothing to see out there. I mean, it could be that I can get over the wall in a different puzzle room and perhaps I'd find something out in the desert. It's possible. I mean, if I had a box, so I can take the box inside with me here, if I wanted to, I think. Would the box allow me to get anywhere? I can get up on these things probably, but that wouldn't take me anywhere. I think that might be it. Unless there's some way to launch myself outside here, because this is an area that I couldn't get to by going around. Could I jump off to the side of this? Let me see something. I think that might just be it. I'm gonna move on. I'm assuming that there's at least one secret thing per level. And I did already find that strange little, like, warped reality place when I went into that dark corner that got filled after I left it. The one with the Minecraft blocks and, like, messed up textures and stuff. So, maybe that was it. Let's go back and let's unlock the replay thing. Since I now have the sigils to do that. Time to play Tetris. Perfect. That's exactly what it's supposed to be. Well, these are awkward. What the hell? This thing's broken. God damn it, Croteam, fix this. Patch it. Okay, that was hub area B. Yeah, hub. This is hub area B, right? Puzzle room 2. Oh no, that was puzzle room 3. Okay, so puzzle room 4 time. Hmm. And this one starts to use the replay things. Okay, and it's got 2 stars, wow. 4 red puzzles and a completely new element of the replay thing and 2 stars. This is gonna be a pretty heavy chamber.
You may wonder why I have created these labyrinths for you. Why you can reach eternity only through struggle. But have faith, for these trials serve the betterment of your kind.
I refuse to have faith. I don't want to be anything like the AI personality Faith. And I think this perhaps might be where the riddle of the Sphinx shows up. That is a Sphinx, isn't it? Remember the walkie-talkie talking about the riddle of the Sphinx? Perhaps it is the riddle of the Sphinx. I just like saying Sphinx. 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 Osiris 6. Knew it was the truth. Now I will tell you of the many perils you will face in your journey through the Duat. Listen well, for the challenges that lie before you are great. And if you do not prove yourself worthy, you may never reach the eternal reed fields of Osiris, and you may be lost forever. From the second death, there is no awakening. The scribe brought forth a great papyrus, and carefully unfolded it before the dying man. And the dying man beheld that it was a map of the Duat, showing the many paths that led to the Tower of Anubis, where his heart was to be weighed. On each of the paths, which threaded through the Duat like the infinite threads woven by Neith, there were marked the dangers that a traveler must face. Also, there were great walls of iron that none but the gods could cross, and gates made of purest light, and so the traveler could not avoid the trials that had been decreed, and could only proceed towards the tower by proving his worth, thus earning the key to each sacred gate. Yeah, this is definitely the blueprint that I'm following. Although in this case, I guess the dying man is more like the dying human race, I suppose. Yep, great walls of iron, gates of light, trials. Key to each sacred gate. The Tower of Anubis. Yep. Arcadia Journal 84. Archive continues to grow, attempting to maintain a semblance of order as difficult as expected. Lost 7 people this week. Statistically speaking, trend should increase. Must focus on realistic goals. Too little time to grieve. Lost 7 people this week. So this is due to the whatever was causing the human, whatever was threatening the extinction of the human race? Too little time to grieve. Feverishly working at this thing before they all die. Chat log. Man, you know what really freaks me out? What? The human body decomposes quite quickly, so all the information stored in chemicals in our brains will be gone really quickly. Dude. But computers and books last a long time, so all our messages, our ideas, our books, it'll all be out there. Our porn. Even being transmitted through space. Yeah, our porn too, I guess. We'll all be gone, but the works of Aristotle will still exist. So will Star Trek, Firefly, Babylon 5, Lord of the Rings, Blade Runner, Cyber something of Planetron 6, Shakespeare, Byron, hell, even video games. Overdrive, Seattle something, Dutch, what? Why is everything asterisked out? Oh, those are the name of, like, pornos or something? I think so. I think it censored the names because they were too explicit. Imagine if aliens find those. Oh god. Whoa. Did you see that? Use. I went up to that because it looks suspicious, right? Because they never expect you to go backwards from where you start, and this looks like a doorway. I was thinking maybe I could just run through it, but there's a use. Fuck you! Entry denied? 2014-12-11. Huh. That's not today's actual date, but it's awfully close to it. I can apparently use that too. What the hell? What is this? If I set my computer's clock to that date, will it allow me through? I've never actually changed my computer's clock. It's automatically synced up, like through the internet, to be always accurate. Can I turn that off and just set it manually? I must be able to, right? Let's see if that works. I feel like that might actually work. Let's do it. Okay, I've gone ahead and done it. It looks like it is automatically synced up with the internet, but it's done at scheduled times. So even though it's actually set to the wrong date at the moment, it should reset at some point, and I can also just manually update now if I want to get it back to how it is before. So the wrong date that I've set it to is sticking for now. The thing is, the date is 2014/12/11, and I don't know if that's year, month, day, or year, day, month. So right now I have it on year... Well, whatever, I have it one way, and we'll see if it works, and if it doesn't, I'll try the other way. So... yeah, let's see if that works. Entry denied. Okay. Let's do that again. So let's set it to the other way. I, like, never use this dialog box, so I find it very confusing. Okay, so the other way is, yeah, month, day, so... December 11th. Right? Yeah. No? Hmm. I really feel like that should work. I wonder if I'd have to, like, restart the game to get it to recognize the time. I don't know if it's pulling the time from my computer as soon as I try to use it. Since it is just right here at the beginning, I'm gonna try restarting the game, actually. So I'll be right back. Okay, well, I tried restarting the game in between changing the date between month, day, or day, month, and neither worked. So maybe that date is just the date this entry denied was stamped down. The fact that I can try to use the entry denied thing, though, suggests otherwise. So I'm almost certain there's more going on here, but yeah, the date thing just didn't work, which is really surprising to me. Because that definitely seems like the sort of thing this game would do. Also, fun fact, when I set my time back by a bit, when I started up the game again, it said, enumerating packages. So there's obviously some sort of a version control save game cloud storage system thing that uses dates to determine what should be what. And didn't seem to like the fact that I had gone back into the past. But it didn't seem to break anything, my saves are still here, and when I set the time forwards again, everything seems to be okay, and it stopped enumerating packages, so... think I'm okay. Anyway, let's move on. The first puzzle you come across is a red one. Let's get a feel for this place before I go in any puzzle rooms. The green one should be very easy. Oh look, another puzzle! And another voice telling me I'm special. And another broken down computer with fragments of nothing. This world is a bad joke perpetuated by a cruel god too dumb to hit the off switch. Well, that's a suspicious pillar. Why is it just hanging out there? Sure, I could stick around here, set my hopes on eternal life, on righting every wrong, but the closest I'll ever get is these words on the wall before you. Epitaph. Child program version blah blah blah. Codename at terminated here. Logic. Fatal flaw in series firmware. Final memory dump. Life's short. The progeny program was Dog. AKA God. That's the rather bitter fellow that left that message over there. It's a paint can there. Look at the sheer scale of that pyramid. To think anyone could have built such things. Yeah, it's definitely the Sphinx over there. Okay, I think that's pretty much it except for this right here.
DNA is information transmitted across time. The living and the dead are part of the same chain, bound together by chemistry. That's true of all species. But humanity has taken this bond further. Thanks to technology, we have access to the thoughts and ideas of people whose physical bodies are long gone. Like you listening to me now. Even though I'm definitely dead at this point, you're part of that chain. You have the capacity to remember.
The burning heart always looks to the highest peak. Uriel Thor. That's the person who left quite a few messages that were not readable as QR codes, ones that didn't pop up when I looked at them. Like the one that helped me solve that Roman numeral clock puzzle that got me the star a long, long time ago. The eagle has landed, or whatever it said. And also the one that said, there are secrets everywhere, sometimes within our very words. I glimpse them, but my eyes cannot read them. How can this be? That was also left by this person. I actually have the quote up. on my other monitor right now, and I'm looking at it. Let's see. 8-0. Okay, this is actually a slightly different version of Uriel 4. In fact, let me bring it up. So if you can see there at the top, for episode 2 QR, there are secrets everywhere, sometimes within our very words. See, the version there is 48.2, and then everything else differs. It's the last point. So the one in the text file is 0.1073. The one that I'm looking at right now in the game world is 0.8560. So the one in the game world is actually a newer iteration of Uriel 4. Okay. Good to know. Anyway, always looks to the highest peak. So is this the riddle of the Sphinx? Always looks the burning heart. Is my heart burning? Burning for knowledge? Sure. Always looks to the highest peak. Like a pyramid? Okay. Did I solve the puzzle? Done. Complete. I win. I win the video games. Riddle solved. What if there's a secret door somewhere around the outside of this? I'm looking for a use to pop up. That'd be way too simple, though. No way. Okay, well, let's get familiar with the replay thing. So let's go into the green chambers and get familiar with this new tool. I already read this, right? Yep. Self-help tutorial. So how long does it record for? Oh, that's really cool. So 5 seconds, according to the bottom left. Or, oh, no, more? Oh, is that up to 5 minutes? Is that what it says? You can record for up to 5 minutes, huh? Holy crap. And the number in the bottom right is the range? Probably in meters or whatever? Of what I'm looking at? Yeah. It looks like the infinity of the skybox is 749. Or actually, maybe that's just where it maxes out. Because I can't imagine the pyramid is as far away as the sky, but they both show the same distance. Anyway, do I have to come back to the machine to stop it? Oh, and then the time counts down in the bottom left. Okay, so I've got almost a full minute of me standing around. Awesome. This is pretty cool. So just stay here for a little bit, and then... yep, this should be good. Go! Thank you, sir. Go back. Shoo! Oh man, that's gonna open up the possibilities, like, really, really far. I think it's gonna get more and more mind-bending to get the stars and the red puzzles and stuff. It's gonna make things a lot harder. Also, I feel like I can make that jump, huh? Look at that. I think I can do it. I knew it. That's like the fastest I've ever broken out of a level before. Whee! Well, the burning heart. burning heart desires the highest peak or whatever. Can I go out to the pyramid? Looks like it's gonna kill me. Nope. Can I jump on my head? Can I jump on the head of my recording? Wait, that doesn't work. What I would have to do is this. So I open the way for me. Cool, and then I just want to stand here. Oh, no, you have no collision. Okay, good to know. Let's do the other green one. I just realized, it can record for 5 minutes. And I can break out of the level. But wait, can my recording break out of the level? It can't, can it? No, there's no way my recording can break out of the level, right? Because I can't get my recording over there, I can only get myself. And if you go outside to the puzzle room, I assume it cancels? Yeah. But if you can get your recording outside, you could have your recording do stuff in other levels for 5 minutes. Potentially very powerful. Double plate. Well, I can guess what I'm supposed to do here. Except... Oh, I see. Oh yeah, I see. So do this one for a second. Then this one. And done. Okay, there's the easy ones down, so now it's just the hard stuff left. But I think I will save those for the next episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.